Welcome student. Now we are already started this lesson, that is ancient India cultural. Okay, ancient India cultural. So let us continue with this lesson, ancient India cultural. We come up to this point, that is the three different texts of Buddhism, that is of Gautam Buddha, Sutta Pitak. Pitak means Pishvi. Okay, Sutta Pitak, that includes the text of Gautam Buddha's teaching and sermons. They are called as a Sukta. Okay, Vinaya Pitaka. The words Vinay means the rules. Vinay Pitaka gives the rules of behavior which bhikkhus and bhikkhunis means in Buddha it is called bhikkhunis. In Buddha Sangha should follow their day to day lives. So there are code of conducts which the bhikkhus and bhikkhunis must follow in their life. Okay, and the third one is the Abhidhamma Pitaka. In this, the Buddhist doctrine has been explained. A text titled Atakatha or Arthakatha, which explains the Tipitaka, is well known. Okay, learned women's composed gathas, narratives, okay, gatha, okay, about their own experiences, they have been compiled in the Teri Gatha, okay, they are in Pali language. Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita text of Hindus, is a part of Mahabharata, Mahakavya. Okay, Bhagavad Gita tells us that each one of us should do our duty without expecting rewards. Okay, without expecting rewards. It also says that the path of devotion to gods is open to all. So Bhagavad Gita is not only text for the Hindus, but also it is a text for the all human beings. Okay, so Bhagavad Gita, because when the Bhagavad Gita are told by the Lord Krishna to Arjuna, before the lakhs of years it was told by Lord Krishna to Vibhaswan, one of the god, okay, like Aditya means the sun. Okay, so the Bhagavad Gita means it tells us about the aim of our human life. Okay, human life. So there are difference of human being as a human being and the animal being. Okay, so one must perform or devote himself for the god or remain in the consciousness of god. So that will be the aim of the human being, and that tells that that aim of the human being told by Lord Krishna to Arjuna in the war situations between Kaurava and Pandavas. This Bhagavad Gita is a well known guide for the human being. Okay, Adi Shankaracharya lived during the 8th century. During the 8th century CE, he emphasized knowledge and renunciation. He wrote, underline the word renunciation. You have to find out the meaning of this renunciation. Okay, he the Adi Shankaracharya, who gives inspirations to all Hindus to become the devotee of Lord Shiva. So he carried out its work like commentaries that explaining the Upanishad, Brahma Sutra and Bhagavad Gita. So he wrote the books like the Upanishad. The meaning of the Upanishad, gaining knowledge while sitting near Guru. Guru means preacher or teacher. Okay, so it is called as Upa means near. Upa means near. So by sitting near Guru, you can get the knowledge. It is called as a Upanishad. Brahma Sutra. Brahma Sutra, the knowledge of knowing the whole universe. The knowledge of knowing the whole universe, whether it is the material world or the spiritual world. Okay, it is called as a Brahma Sutra. And Bhagavad Gita, as it is told by the Lord Himself, the God Himself, so we must have a knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Students, you also read the book Bhagavad Gita in Sanskrit, or it's the translation in Marathi, that is Jnaneshwari. You can read the Bhagavad Gita as it is compiled by the Santa Jnaneshwar as a Jnaneshwari. Okay, so one can read the Jnaneshwari or Bhagavad Gita, both. Okay, he established the four mutt in four directions of India, Bharat. Okay, at Badrinath, Dwarika, Jagannathpuri and Sringeri. So from these two directions, he gives the knowledge to the whole community. Okay, this is the picture of Adi Shankaracharya. In the childhood, he becomes a sannyasi. From the childhood, he becomes the sannyasi. Okay. Kautilya wrote Arthashastra. Kautilya means Chanakya. I don't know, in previous years, at the time of our childhood, there was a serial of Dr. Chandra Prakash Dwivedi. It is called Chanakya. Okay. And Chanakya also having the name, that is Kautilya. Kautilya means the one who has curly hairs, that is called Kautilya. Okay, in Arthashastra, this Chanakya discuss the length, what the constitutes of an excellent administrative system. So we can get the ancient knowledge from Chanakya, how the king must perform his activity, or he how to administer the whole empire. Okay, treatise on grammar. As we know that the Sanskrit is an ancient language of Hindu literature. Okay, we follow the Sanskrit as we today speaks in Marathi day-to-day life. So in ancient time, the peoples also talk with each other in general, okay, in Sanskrit. So Sanskrit is a very vast language, having the very vast grammar, and it is very simple language also. Okay, the Ashtadhyayi, written by grammarian Panini. Panini is the first grammarian who wrote the grammar of Sanskrit in his epics, that is Ashtadhyayi. Okay, this Panini is considered to be the standard work on Sanskrit grammar. Patanjali wrote Mahabhashya on Sanskrit grammar. It explains the principles of given by the Panini's Ashtadhyayi. So here are the two books. First one, Ashtadhyayi, underline this, of Panini, and Mahabhashya of Rishi Patanjali. Okay, today Patanjali is famous for yoga because of Ramdev Baba. Okay, so here is the information about the Arthashastra written by Chanakya. This is a work done by Kautilya. It consists the detailed discussions of administrative matters, such as duties of king, criteria for selecting minister, system of defense, types of forts, and formation of an army, plans for espionage, organizations of the treasury and other offices, judicial system, investigation of theft, types of punishment. So the Arthashastra give thorough knowledge about the administration for of the of an empire or a bureaucracy. So this is the very good book, we can say. The next point is Arsh or classical epics. Arsh means the epics or the written documents by rishis. So by rishis or a sage means santa or sannyasis. It is called as Arsh Sahitya, okay, Arsh literature. So here Ramayana and Mahabharat are the two Arsh epics of ancient India. Arsh means composed by rishis or sages, santa, sadhu, okay. The Ramayana was composed by Rishi Valmiki. We must know the story of becoming Valmiki. Valmiki basically belongs by birth to the Koli, okay. And he is a robber, or we can say dacoit, okay, dacoits. But after the meeting, Narada, he becomes Valmiki. Okay, so one must get the knowledge from a sacred person. Okay, so that sacred person can change your whole life. The main character of Ramayana is Sri Ram, Bhagwan Sri Ram. Mahabharat has been composed by sage Vyasa. There is one Subhashit in a Sanskrit, that is the Vyaso Chishtam Jagat Sarvam. The meaning of this Subhashit is that the what is the world having is the Uchishta means Ushta knowledge. Okay, Ushta knowledge. Ya jagat je kai knowledge hai ते व्यासांनी ऑलरेडी गेन केलेलं आहे आणि त्यांचं ते उष्ट आहे नॉलेज. ओके, सो मच इंटेलिजंट और नॉलेजेबल पर्सन द सेग व्यास इज. वी ऑल नो दॅट द महाभारत वॉज रिटन बाय भगवान व्यास. द इट्स मेन थीम ऑफ इन इज द वॉर बिटवीन कौरवा अँड पांडवाज. इट ऑल्सो टेल्स अस अबाउट लॉर्ड कृष्णाज लाईफ. महाभारत प्रोवाइड्स a comprehensive picture of the various human sentiment and emotions and their consequences. Asa mhanatat ki je Mahabharatat ahe te jagat ahe. Okay, jagat kahi ghatna ghadli tari ti Mahabharata madhe tyacha mool astach asta, pan je Mahabharata madhe nahi te jagat kuthes tumhala disnar nahi asa Mahabharata vishayi sangitla jata. ओके, इतकं डिटेल ह्युमन इमोशन्स त्याच्यामध्ये लिहिली गेलेली आहे. प्रत्येकाचं नेचर कॅरेक्टर हे त्याच्यामध्ये लिहिलं गेलेलं आहे. ओके, वन मस्ट रीड ऑर सी महाभारत सिरियल. ओके, समटाईम्स देअर इज अ सच अ पिरियड इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ लँग्वेज लिटरेचर अँड आर्ट दॅट इट्स ग्लोरी रिमेन्स अनडिमिनिश इवन लेटर ऑन. Today also we found the ancient temples in India also and throughout the world also. We get the knowledge about the architecture from these temples, because at the ancient times temples were at the center point of the social life. Okay, so the whole social life was concentrated in the temples. The art, literature, etc. produced in such period is said to be a classical. Raghuvamsha and Kumar Sambhava by Kalidas. Kalidas is the famous literary person at the ancient period, in the period of, we can say, Raja Bhoj or Vikramaditya. Okay, Kiratarjuniya by Bharvi and Shishupala Vadha by Magha, okay, are well-known compositions of the ancient period written in a classical Sanskrit language. So Sanskrit is a very flourished language in the ancient period, Later on, many languages derived from this Sanskrit language. That languages are called as a Prakrit language, Pali, Ardhamagadhi, and today we have 18 official language. That is the exception of the Tamil language. Okay, Tamil is an ancient language as a parallel to Sanskrit language. Okay, theaters. From ancient times, the India, because of prosperity, we also developed different fine arts like theater, performing theater arts. Okay, so India has an ancient traditions of telling stories through songs, music, and dance. These arts have been discussed in a great details in Natya Shastra by Bharat Muni. When these arts are presented with the supporting dialogues, they are known as a theater. Among the ancient Sanskrit plays, Swapna Vasavadatta by Bhas, the Natya Shastri, and Abhijnana Shakuntala by Kalidasa, etc., are the famous among the ancient literature. Today also in Marathi language we have Sangeet Natak, Sangeet Manapman, Sangeet Saushankalya. They are derived from this type of theaters. Okay, Ekach Pyala of Gadkari. Okay, now the next point is a narrative literature. Narrative means telling story. Okay, in the ancient times, storytelling was used to educate people through entertainments. The Gunadhyas Brihat Katha, written in a language called Paishachi, is one ancient language, is a well known. So in Paishachi language, Gunadhya, at the parallel time of Samrat Harshvardhan, we can say, he wrote down the stories, different stories in Brihat Katha. Brihat means manifolded stories, Katha means stories. Okay, and we also know the Panchatantra is composed by Pandit Vishnu Sharma. He is an excellent example of narrative literature. These texts has been translated into many languages. Similarly, the Bauddha Jataka tales are also very well known. So in ancient language, storytelling having the different sect of the Sanskrit language or different Prakrit languages. Okay, the lifestyle of the people. The next point is about the lifestyle of the people. Okay, because India is prosperous at its ancient times. Okay, so India developed a prosperous lifestyle also. Okay, the literatures of ancient India sheds light on the way of life of the common people of the time. Those were prosperous times. Due to the flourishing internal as well as foreign trade, the society was divided into the different castes. There were organizations of traders as well as the artisans. These organizations were called as shrenis. The trade was carried out by sea as well as land routes throughout the world. Okay, at the ancient period we have a trade relations with the Arabs and Europe also. Indian goods like fine textile, ivory, precious stones, spices, beautifully made earthen pots were in a great demand in foreign countries. The main crops were rice, wheat, barley, lentil means masoor dal. Okay, the diet of the peoples, including the food items made from this, besides meat, fish, milk, ghee and fruits also, the items in the includes in the diet of the people. The people mostly wore cotton garments through silk, and woolen garment were also worn. Their clothes resembled today's dhoti, uparne, mundase, sarees, etc. So the wearing sari is prevailed in India from ancient period near about 10,000 years. Okay, so sari is a unique identification of Bharatiya culture. Sari is a unique identification of Bharatiya culture. Okay, so such type of dhotars, the wearing dhotis, wearing these dhotis having different types. Okay, the Gujarati dhoti habit of wearing that dhotis having the in a different manner. Wearing of dhotis in a Gujarati is a different manner, in Maharashtrian in a different manner, in the Bhojpuri also it has a different kind of wearing style. Okay, so wearing dhoti is having its own culture, dhoti. Okay, uparne means uparne means the having a towel like cotton, towel like cotton, because of the hot climate, Indians at the ancient period used to wear the uparnes. Okay, mandase means the mukut, we can say mukut or pagadi, such type of mundases were identifications of the Indian way of having the different types of styles of wearing dresses. Okay, the concept of stitching clothes was introduced in India during the Kushana period. So the stitching of clothes were introduced by the Kushana. Before that we having the plain clothes of wearing. Okay, so students, now we will going to stop here and we will continue with these points in the next lecture. Okay, in the next lecture, so we will going to stop here and in the next lecture we will complete this lesson. Okay, thank you.